Hello, replay viewers. So I'm doing, as the title says, some node.js practice. So before I get started, just gonna pull up YouTube chat on my phone and post to the Twitters and such. And to Facebook. Because I've not posted to Twitter before from my Twitch update stream, and I don't know how it truncates it because my post is longer than 140 characters. Okay, it also sticks Twitch URL in there. If I want to fit more next time, I'll probably leave out the live coding URL. Of course, usually I forgot to turn off automatic posting from live coding because I was going to do it manually instead because I wanted to mention triple byte. And I'll just delete the auto posts, unless it doesn't do it. Cut off. Well, that's not good. Now I mentioned this random person named Live. I have to report that as a bug, I guess. Here as well. Oh yeah, there it is. Yeah, my live stream is not showing up in my YouTube app. Yeah, that's stupid. I should just turn off auto posting because it doesn't even, when it auto posts, it doesn't include the video preview. And I need to get an auto poster for Twitch. To-do list. Or should I? What's up with you, YouTube? Are you even on? I'll have to check on here. Agile. I don't know if this is agile. Cool, more spam follows. I'll take them as long as they stay followed. Let's open back up YouTube streaming dashboard. For the like, Brandy Morgan, if that is your name. Oh, wow. Alright. Tunes back on. Got what's going on with YouTube. I'm offline. Or maybe the page just loaded from cache. Or refresh. Viewers may be experiencing minor issues. Let's go away. Okay. I'm streaming, but I don't know. Not showing up in my Android app. I can't really follow along in chat because I can't afford to keep it open on the laptop here because one, I don't have the screen real estate, and two, I don't have the CPU power. Just streaming from a crappy Chromebook. And so right now, so I have a project kind of set up for this little toy game thingy. I'm just trying to figure out basically how I want to do things the right way in NPM. So I have my test script, and then I have a watch script as well, which just adds an extra option on for Mocha. And I'm trying to figure out how I officially specify the entry point into my app. But I want to actually execute to get this game running in the console. Okay, there's main. How to actually run from that entry point. Is there an npm or node command that will automatically jump into my entry point? Blank, you are not about blank. Maybe the entry point is just used for require. Okay, so I guess it doesn't really apply to an application because it's not meant to be required. Man files, eh? That's pretty cool. There's a lot to this. Okay, maybe I'm really looking for another canonical npm script, like test. Maybe I want one like run. Oh, that's cool. It indents it automatically. I think I'll define start. Doesn't exist. So now I will make it. Hi world. Here game.js. Now this should run. Nope. Status 126. Permission denied. Oh yes. It's not executable. Do it again. And status 2. Syntax error near unexpected token. Didn't expect a string? Why not? Quote, I, quote. Hello, Inoa Golang. Apparently I can't even get a hello world to work, so I'm debugging a hello world, which I guess is better to do now than in an interview. Debug log doesn't even give an error message. Silly lifecycle. Alright, what if I just run game.js? Yeah, because it's just trying to run it probably as a bash script. So yeah, we don't necessarily need to make this a standalone binary. Hello system is. So it's not executable, and we'll just run it with node as normal. Alright, now npm start should work. Alright, yeah, can close that. Yay, it works. All right, cool, cool. Looking up some async await JavaScript stuff on my phone, which is running Chrome, so let me pull that up. Welcome back, J Tryon. How are you today, tonight, this morning, whatever it is for you? Fine New Year's. I went over my sister's house, which she bought new this year. We just had a small little get together with her husband, my other sister, and her husband, and my sister's husband's friend and his girlfriend. Oh, cool. I don't know if I call it ironic, maybe a coincidence, although it's, I don't know, not all that unlikely, maybe. Alright, what was I looking at? Jam.js. And different stuffs. Cool, cool. The restream itself had a delay. I hadn't thought about that. Anyways, I hope it's not too bad. I'm kind of used to like a 15-second delay from watching Twitch. I don't think my OBS is getting overloaded this time. I bumped it down to 20 FPS. Only 26 frames dropped, so... does that mean it's buffering about like a second's worth of video? Animations. Okay, on live coding, you haven't been one that's less than 15 seconds. I don't know, I was assuming live coding had less delay since it's smaller. It hasn't needed to add in the extra whatever infrastructure pipeline that Twitch put in place that made the delay. So I remember back, I don't know, 2 or so years ago, didn't have much delay at all, like less than 5 seconds. Mm-hmm. This is interesting. Yeah, I didn't know ES2017 async await and generators only worked at the top level or single frame. Oh, live coding had a similar change that Twitch did now, then, I guess. Well, I guess that means they're getting more successful. ZMY. So I am right now just being kind of boring and reading about async JavaScript APIs and generators and coroutines. Maybe it's not boring for everyone, it's not boring for me, which is why I'm reading about it, but maybe some people came to see coding, but I'm pretty much just using a simple program as a launch pad for researching, studying, basically for this interview coming up. Nice performance benefits. Want to allocate extra. Hello, Aaron R. Cox. Extra generators or promises. On the other hand, I was less efficient because the 5-year calls yield as each fiber allocates a stack. I wonder what fibers do that make them not compatible with the browser. New tab? No. Oh yeah, this site doesn't even want to load. Oh well. Guess that doesn't exist. My async library is fast, fool. Node fibers. What are you all about? C and C++. That's cool. Does that mean it should be pretty fast? radically simpler way to deal with async in JavaScript. Is that what you're gonna say? Ooh, deprecated. Nice. Alright, and what's radioactive all about? It's not. then why is that the first result on Google? Latest commit 9 days ago? Okay. Underscore. That looks kind of messy. I'm interested in that. Meteor does client-side fibers. Routines won't work on the web. All right, let's look at the syncify again. Open that tab back up. And I'm grinding my computer to a halt because I'm opening a lot of tabs. And I thought I'd close this one. Triggered. So it's like programming in continuation passing style. Hello, Jabakcha. How are you doing tonight? So right now I'm kind of just reading about different styles of asynchronous programming in JavaScript. Take a look back at the streamline.js. So we kind of reused the same callback. Hello, JHJ Jang. To the database and basically just want to wait for it to connect and then and get connection object back. Interesting. Futures. Oh, cool. I'll bookmark this. And see what my options are. Make a new folder for async. Don't know, there were so many different ways to do it, but of course there are, it's a node. Do I have any other bookmarks about async stuff. On bookmarks, update. See if radioactive.js is still a thing. Remove all the callbacks. Yeah, callbacks, callbacks. Functional reactive API. All right, there are two libraries called radioactive. Oh wait. This one's actually about nuclear decay. Suppose you have 1 kilogram of cesium-134 with a half-life of 30 years and 1 kilogram of uranium-238 with a half-life of 4.5 billion years. I'm going to give you one of the blocks. You have to sleep with it tonight like a teddy bear. Which one do you want? I want the uranium. Bit quiet tonight. That's alright. Missing native functional reactive API for JavaScript. It's 2 years old. Right. Or a year and a half. there's a meetup for Radioactive, or at least there was. Alright, let's bookmark it down here at the README. Do it manually. Async await. This can be useful too. Half a year stale. Another asynchronous library. To read about WinJS. How long is this? 4 years. Hmm. Well, the documentation is gone, so I guess I'm not going to read that. My coroutines won't work on the web. Why are you no coros? Okay, the node can do this, and it implements functions in C++. Oh, yeah, user kind of crash and suspend host activations. This is why ECMAScript uses generators for the async, which are only single frame, so they don't have to rejigger the whole stack handling thing. And suspend their own function activation. Build an operator only generated function can use. Task.js. There's another one. It's probably dead. Returns a promise. Task explicitly yields the promise. What now? Just enough power to bring on blocking IO in a synchronous style without being threads light. Thanks for the follow. Chibakcha 22. Is that a clone of Chibakcha that you went in chat with? Now we got 6 viewers on Twitch. Are you view bombing? Let me check on YouTube on my phone. See if my stream is showing up in the app yet, so I can monitor chat on YouTube. Yeah, it's about time for me to take an eye break anyway. Nope. Why are you doing this, YouTube? Oh, and all your bots left. Goodbye. Away from the screen. Tighten the little screw on my chair so it stops squeaking so much. Probably head up the bathroom. Figure out what the hell this guy is saying. Welcome back, Denver Cowboy. And, did I say hi to ZMY? Well, hello to you too. And I just saw my email and I was away that system is followed me on live coding. And thank you for that. Yeah, previously got live coding follower notifications through Chrome, but now I switched to Firefox. So I didn't have those live coding follower notification emails triggering notifications on my phone going to my, you know, top level of my Google inbox. But now I'll start marking them for that. Couple push-ups. One, because I don't exercise enough, and two, maybe it'll help wake me up a little bit. I don't know how the camera angle is. But I do sissy push-ups where I go on my knees rather than my feet because my wrist gets sore when I do regular push-ups. But I just try to do more of these than I would regular push-ups. Do some crunches. Thirty crunches and I don't remember, about 15 sissy push-ups, maybe. Alright, let's get back to getting on well. I should actually update my stream title. So right now I'm just researching asynchronous programming. I don't know, paradigms for Node. Hello, I carry your curry. You dropped in the channel last time, didn't you? Am I ready for what? For the interview? Well, I don't know. Trying to be more ready, hence why I'm practicing and studying. Yeah. Guess that's about all I can say. Guess you never really know if you're ready, unless you know what they're gonna ask. They actually do give a pretty good guide on what types of things to expect. So, based on that and what I want to study, no, I'm not really ready yet. So, but I've got tonight and tomorrow to get ready. And where am I going? Here. How hard is it going to be? Well, it's gotten like mixed feedback in terms of hardness on Glassdoor. I don't know if it's really supposed to be kind of a test as much as it is kind of getting to know my programming style and areas that I'm strong in. I mean, I guess it's going to be somewhat of a test too, but yeah, I did like the screening coding test and I did well on that. But of course they'll want to validate that and make sure I wasn't, you know, I don't know. Hello, Yana, Seattle. Were you here last time too? Changes. You and who outside to not do that last time? Hello, SJ Pablo. Or you and Yana Seattle. Oh, probably that's what you meant. Cool, cool. Is that usually what you do when you smoke pot and tune into some programming streams? Researching a sync programming styles in node.js / JavaScript. Health conscious? I don't know. Not in particular. If anything, when I started having depression, that kind of made me become more health conscious. But hair loss is just hereditary in my family. But yeah, actually, I think mine is better than my dad's so far, so I'm not really worried about it. Probably just gonna get some medication for it, actually. That finasteride. I was taking some mail order from India before, but yeah. but who really knows what you're getting with that, so I stopped doing that. But next time I go to the doctor, I think I'll ask for a prescription. Hello, Stephen Ha. That's weird to me if JavaScript isn't capitalized. But node is fine. I do the hashtags on Twitch because they do that in the creative section. And on YouTube, we just make the title look good. I need something to update all the titles at the same time. Although live coding is stupid and doesn't allow you to have very long titles at all. My poor little Chromebook is struggling so hard. Trying to run Firefox and stream with all these tabs. Did you re-edit it? I don't know. Okay, there are no new product changes. What are you talking about? Restream. I'll put on some music. That'll make it more entertaining than just waiting for Firefox to load pages. I don't know, maybe I shouldn't even stream this, it's just slowing down my whole system. Probably won't stream anymore until I get a new system, but for tonight, since you guys are already here, I'll finish out the stream for as long as I was going to go. Alright, what am I listening to? Did I listen to this? Plug in my headphones. Mm, 2016 is trash. A lot of people are complaining about it. As far as years in the past couple years is pretty par for the course for me, although, you know, past several years haven't really been too great anyway, so. Okay, so here I can just say. Why is this showing as new? I should turn off new tab highlighting. These aren't even loaded and they're marked as new. So it won't be so bad. Yeah, let's hope. If this triple byte thing goes well, it should be at least an interesting year for me. Hopefully good overall. Tab utilities, appearance. I'm listening to a country song. So I'm just listening to all songs named Wild Wild. Changes start from January 8th. What happens then? I have these style options here. But now I remember my this coloring actually I've defined in a user style. So now this is a fiddling with Firefox UI user styles stream. Dire Straits, I thought you were better than this. No, no thanks. I'll pass on the reggae. Too short. Unread tabs. Yeah, let's not do that. Cool. Alright. Do you update the title live coding? Alright. Yeah, play please. Actually, I'm reading now, so I don't really want to have songs with lyrics. Assert some state fails. Push current home. Fail if the other thread of control were not there. It's still true in the yield version, however. That's also true in the async callback role we have today. In practice, from years of experience with eventlet and twisted, it's not really a problem. Libraries which are known to switch are pretty easy to recognize. Switch. Since they almost always are performing socket or await operations, a library primitive for recording and synchronization can be designed to manage the switching as it occurs to take that into account. Stack slicing. Sign in to discuss. No, not twice. I think I want to read up on stack slicing later at some point. Let's put that on my to read list. Software. And under that, I guess I'll put it under programming. I don't know. It's kind of a fine line. here's a move. Task.js has moved. Synchronous function call, as you mentioned, it's just an asynchronous call to manipulate each and every single function from stuff. Happens if Munge accesses Obj and does nasty things with it per minute. I cannot believe Munge's documentation will inspect its source. No matter whether Munge yields or not. I don't know. See. Okay. Another run can be injected for a topless function. blah, blah, blah. All right, let's move on. Task.js. Hello, D. Gazelle. Task.js. What? Operative concurrency for ESX, why? Who says JavaScript IO has to be ugly? Where? Task.js.org. When? As soon as your JS engine supports generators. Generators plus policies equals tasks. Task.js is an experimental library for ESX that makes sequential blocking IO simple and beautiful using the power of JavaScript's new YLE operator. Tasks are interleaved like threads, but they're cooperative rather than preemptive. They block on promises with yield. For example, using a jQuery. Yield Ajax. Yield where else? Let's figure out. The promise is A. If we have async await, Neil Joy. This is 3 years old. What are the issues? One wants to use RSVP.js and one wants to remove it. Pinky swear, promise. April 2014. Topic: music callbacks. RSS promises has been rocking through the JavaScript community for several years. Some people don't like callbacks. Other people think the promises are even worse. And since generators became available on Google Chrome and Node, it became three-sided. And there is another approach available on all major versions of Node: the fibers. Approach to the problem has multiple drawbacks. So concerning JS and JavaScript friendliness. Order of decreasing importance. That's most important. Platform availability and distribution. Scalability. Choose the country HTTP request, start a committed result into a database, and move on. Function get another thing, parse, insert database. And that's the second HTTP call, but we can chain it to the database then. Generators. Semicoroutines. Articles to read. I might just bookmark those. It's wrong generally functions right over there. I'm just like proper functions and they're lacing. Okay, wait. Open library queue. Try catch. Meal. Okay. Second request and get the stuff and do the stuff and go to the database insert. And some disadvantages. My order could be confusing. Yeah, it's only single frame. Power code. This needs to support compilation, sorts, maps, and long stack traces. And if you use a native generator, it's possible to not optimize by the VA engine nor not as optimized by regular generators for your code. Oh, I'm gonna catch up. Convert all third party code and then use a mixed approach. Okay. Wait for. What is this? Oh, hello. Gil Hermaid Vinicius. Here we do. This repo is 2 years old. Trigger warning. Thank you. important to get enough fiber in your diet. This is also 3 years old. Hello, Dr. Denisop. How are you this fine night or morning or whatever it is where you are? Spaghetti face. 6 minute read. A sign, maybe this bottom bar will go away. Well, bye, Dennis. Callbacks versus the generator. Oh, error handling. Caught exceptionally. different in another library. So I'm going to look at comparison with ES7 Babel regenerator. Experimenting with async await in node.7 nightly. A sec. Hello, Hem Street. I'm gonna switch to my standing desk right now, which is just this cardboard box on my desk here. But it works. Let's go async await landed in V8. Yay. Fetch data. Trace then catch. Can wait on premises. This will halt the execution in a non-blocking way. Wait for the results and returns it. Deny will be through. Could trace then. Then do nothing. Pony food. Sleep turn in a new promise. Fix resolve. Sets timeout to resolve. Yeah, why not just pass resolve function directly instead of making a lambda that calls resolve. What problem is it trying to solve? That's a good question to ask.
functions proposal. My shortcut for keeping a window horizontal control display. Just do that. Can I have bookmarks always there? That's much easier. Description for this bookmark. It seems redundant now with async await. I'll just put these in a folder. Taking notes on things I've looked up so far. So this one uses fibers. And this one's functional reactive API. This one gives you basically callback shortcuts. Okay. Yeah, this doesn't use promises or anything. You just write a function that calls those functions and treats it like data and hand it off to Radioactive React. Understanding JavaScript's async await. One stays out here. Generators, based one in the generators folder. Promises, generators. And promises plus generators equals async await. Blah, blah. Those reasons. Hello, Jeriquiv. Errors are swallowed silently, so I can sign all promises. Plus, we have try catch blocks around await expressions and caught exceptions, regardless of whether they're raised in the body of your async function or while it's suspended during await, will reject the promise returned by the async function. Yeah? We would allow rich try catch conventions and some way you want to. npm run. Babelfy. This address bar. This one now again. Here. Person. So this is using a wraparound generators too. I think I'll make a folder for fibers too. Is probably just using generators as well. Coroutines or semi-coroutines. learning to navigate this bookmark pain. Without the UI actually updating, except for the tooltips and a little status bar down the bottom there. I guess I could take these notes out because put this in the fibers folder now. So this is basically my current preference of what I'd most like to use. Async await is first, and then the functional reactive stuff. And there are those other FRP libraries that I haven't even looked into yet, so this could become a folder. RxJS and BaconJS. And then we have fibers, and then we have nicer callbacks, then we have generators, or wrappers around generators that are like what async await is doing now, but before that was standardized. And then this is just a more general article about real coroutines. I guess this is kind of more discussion than really an actionable issue. Regenerator. What is that? Dude. I just closed that. Facebook library. Alright, 1 second. I'm gonna go refill my water. Serious. Oh, I'm back in 2013. Some generator transpiler. Yeah, I'm not even going to bookmark this. Just a standalone generator transpiler, which is now just a feature of Babel. Controversial state of JavaScript. Published a year ago, 10-minute read. This isn't just like npm run. And I guess not, because then you gotta put a script in your package JSON. What did I start today? I'm just streamlining JS. Something that I would want to use. How old is it? I'm sitting back down in my chair now. Oh, I forgot to tighten that little screw thingy. Oh, kind of acting. Yeah. Alright, wait, and what is the, TypeScript integration. Integrated with Babel, that's good. Is already pretty tight. It's still squeaking. Probably need to grease it. Well, it's not a specific job just yet, so. There's a company called Triple Byte. They're kind of like a recruiting firm, but it's not just like your regular recruiter. Like, you just give your resume to a human and they try to find the jobs for you. Hello, DRMJG. They have kind of more sophisticated process. Starting with like an online coding test, and they're trying to basically make the whole, well, a lot of the process data driven. That test is very data driven because it's automated, and if you pass that test, then you talk to their people, which is, you know, what this interview is going to be now.
that I'm prepping for, and then they kind of supposedly get to know me, type of programmer I am, where are my strengths, what is my style, I guess, and then they have kind of a system or some, I don't know, theories for matching you up with companies based on what those companies are looking for, and kind of the process is based on like the data they've gotten for success rates for, like, you know, asking companies different things like what kind of programmers they're looking for, then giving them those types of programmers and seeing, you know, how well they do in that company's final interview round, which, you know, you still have to go through with each company they would send you to. So sorry if that was more than you really wanted to know, but it's kind of trouble bite. VS Code is awesome. There's a loader and require hooks. Files will be compiled on the fly. Interesting. Flows and globals. Ambient type definitions. Hello, ID 37921-7832. Streamline JS and TypeScript. Streamline script for arbitrary commands. That's cool.
npm run script. So that wasn't this thing, was it? NPM run script. Is that the same as NPM run? Oh, yeah. This may come in handy when I want to port this bash script to npm. These packages. Let me just make a folder here. npm. Getting started 3 years ago. Maybe it's not actually something I would use then. But I'll just bookmark it. Bookmark npm run as well. names, bookmark names. Understand what this does. Okay, just a subset of Bash script. It's kind of weird. I don't know why I would want that. Into this.
Andre and George GRZ. Oh, Adobe Flash has crashed. Does this chat room work without Flash? Open up another instance to see if I get messages on there. No, they don't on here. To the weeds of NPM issues.
Hello, G Kong. So right now I'm just kind of in the weeds reading about NPM stuff. Is there XML in my NPM thread? Yeah, ephemeral Talon Lotus, that's... I've been reading about all those things all night. And... So yeah, I think I have a good handle on it now. I've just kind of got into the weeds of NPM. And hello, Ben Hart, who you see. Your style for GitHub. Yes, this one. Show linked issue names. That will be useful. binary to npm called npm exec that does basically what npm run script does, but without the npm conf command line parsing of npm itself. Proves the situation described. So flags lines run script. This thread is too long.
Whatever. Thank you. reading anymore. Put this in my to read later. Web Pretensions Experiment. I'm gonna make a folder for when does at large. Put that in there. Sad state of web development. I love working with the web. Can I control click to select? Nope. Control and move my cursor down to select something non-adjacent, except the cursor is not visible. Oh. That is not what I wanted. Web is the most hostile software engineering environment imaginable.
No, I don't want to hard key. Write wrapper is an intermediate library that live outside of your application core while consuming hypermodules. Keep your opinions to those intermediate libraries while keeping hypermodules discrete. In this sense, you could think of a hypermodule as Lodash function bind, an intermediate library as Lodash. Use Lodash as an example because it's one of the best representations out there today of what constitutes a hypermodular library. An hypermodular? That's hundreds of components, but opinions are not one of them. An ecosystem that's founded on intermediate libraries and top hypermodules could fare much better. The bulk of implementation, testing, and documentation would fall on hypermodules, while opinions and plumbing could be kept in an intermediate layer, or only just it's starting to even consider. Presumably, code in the intermediate layer could be bulkier, but that should be something that, with proper and better tooling, a feature like tree shaking could take care of. Hello, Tritka. I'm probably not going to be streaming for too much longer. I'm getting tired and it's getting late here. So how are you doing this late night or whatever it is where you are? Into my read later marks. Hello, diagram. Because I'm kind of done for now. Maths.
Yeah, I don't really know where to bookmark this. Is this product management or software engineering? I'll just put it under programming. So where am I now after reading all that stuff? Okay, so I'm using async await, which means using APIs that return promises. I guess that means I'm going to find a library that either promisifies the node streams or standard in-out API or some library API that already provides the IO streams in promise form. Something like the readline API. Hello, Singleton. I think I'm just wrapping up the stream now. Figure out this script to define my entry point for npm start. Instead of the game, I'm going to call it a game. I may have to add some babble foo in here too. Oh. So I guess that'll be it for tonight. Hello, KNS. You just caught me at the end of my stream. I'll drop 296 frames. Does that mean I'm like 150 seconds behind? At 20 FPS. Oh well. I guess I'll see when I stop streaming how long it takes to stop. Alright. Good night, everyone. Stay chill.